मार्कंडेय उपाज प्रपन्नस्म्यंघ्रीमूलं ते प्रपन्नाभयदं हरि जन्मायोयापि विबुद्धा मुह्यन्ति ज्ञानकाशया। ट्रांसलेशन। श्री मार्कंडेय सेड, ओ लॉर्ड हरि, आई टेक शेल्टर ऑफ द सोल्स ऑफ योर लोटस फीट विच बेस्टो फियरलेसनेस अपॉन ऑल हु सरेंडर टू देम। इवन द ग्रेट डेमिगड्स आर बिल्डेड बाय योर इल्यूजरी एनर्जी which appears to them in the guise of knowledge. Purport. Conditioned souls are attracted to material sense gratification, and thus they meticulously study the workings of nature. Although they appear to be advancing in scientific knowledge, they become increasingly entangled in their false identification with the material body, and therefore increasingly merge into ignorance. The Markandeya Rishi says, praying to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hari, I take shelter of the souls of your lotus feet. This is the latest instruction, you see, latest instruction of the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Sarvadharman paritejya mamekam saranam vraja. Antam srapapebhya mukheshyami maashucha. Giving up all sorts of religion, only take shelter of me. Mamekam saranam vraja. Only take shelter of me. Take shelter, the lotus feet of Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Thereby also is giving assurance. If someone may think, if I will give up all sorts of religion, then I will commit some sin, irreligion. Irreligion means sin. If I give up all sorts of religion, then I will commit sin, irreligion. If such apprehension will be there, Supreme Lord Krishna assures, Antam srapapebhyo mukheshyami maasucha. Don't fear. Don't fear. I will protect you from all sorts of sinful reactions. I will destroy all sorts of sinful reactions. Don't fear. This is the significant word, maasucha. Don't fear. That means fearlessly you take shelter. Fearlessly you take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna. You understand? Here's the Markandeya Rishi. Say the same thing. I take shelter of the souls of the lotus feet which bestow fearlessness upon all who surrender to Thee. Surrender to them. Do you understand? This is the most significant word, fearlessness. This is the only place, the only shelter of all living entities to take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna, which is a place of fearlessness. Isn't it? In this material world, people are always in fearful state. Every step, they are facing so much danger, so much trouble, so much problem. Always in fearful state. You understand? Pade pade vipadam. That is stated in Srimad Bhagavatam. Pade pade vipadam. Every step there is danger. This is material world. It's full of danger, full of misery, full of fear. You understand? All are in this state. All are in anxiety. You understand? Nobody is free from fear here. You understand? What is the reason of fear?
Identification with the body.
Therefore you fear.
Also, I guess so.
You just concoct in your mind, or are you quoting some authority?
I'm quoting Prabhupada from one of his purports.
Prabhupada said that. Yeah. You identify yourself with body, therefore you fear. What will happen to my body? Isn't it? What will happen to my body? The body may finish. I'll die. Yes. That is the purport. But authority, Srimad Bhagavatam says, Bhayam ditiyabhinivesata syat. Do you understand? Mr. Peter, you should go to the authority. Become Vaishnava. Vaishnava always quotes authority. Vaishnavam sloka bhaktaram. This is one of the definitions of Vaishnava. Do you understand, Mr. Peter? Huh? Vaishnavam sloka bhaktaram. Vaishnav is bona fide, sadhu, guru, acharya. He always quotes authority. Vedic authority. Do you understand? And thereby, quoting Vedic authority, bona fide, he defeats all bogus philosophy. Do you understand? Unless you quote authority, nobody will listen to you. What are you saying? Do you understand? Bhayam ditiyo vinivesa tasyat is most important. Your attention is, as you say, in your material body. Isn't it? Soul attention is in this body. Because this body is very dear to you, and you think it is everything for me. Everything for me. Isn't it? And you are running after fulfilling the bodily needs. Isn't it? Bodily needs. What the body needs. What are the needs of the body?
Eating, sleeping, mating, defending.
Yes.
Ahara, nidra, vayava, ipunam. Eating, sleeping, defending, and mating.
These are the bodily needs, isn't it? And all are running after this. Those who have identified themselves with the body. Who is he? Sit in proper posture. Yeah. Don't sit like that. Krishna is there, Supreme Personality of Godhead. We should sit proper posture. Otherwise, you'll commit offense and Krishna will be angry and inflict very severe punishment upon you. Do you understand this thing? You don't know. This is your ignorance, but I know it. Therefore, I caution you. Do you understand? A small child, he doesn't know. Do you understand? Ignorant. He goes and to catch the burning fire. The father knows fire will burn. So he says, hey, drags him. No, don't catch. That will burn. Isn't it? Similarly, you don't know ignorance. You are committing so much offense. How Krishna will be angry and inflict very severe punishment upon you. I know it. I am your well-wisher. Don't think in yourself so much embarrassed. Do you understand? Yes. Yeah. So this body is everything. All are running after this bodily needs. Eating, sleeping, defending and mating. Isn't it? Trying very hard, making different plans, projects, how to get more and more comforts, give more and more happiness and comforts to this mighty body, temporary body, isn't it? Still, they cannot get happiness. Still, they are in anxiety. Still, they are always in fearful state. Isn't it? Though they, one may be very intelligent here in this material world, material intelligent person. Do you understand? Mr. Peter, as he says, scientific knowledge, you see. The material scientists, they are considered to be very, very intelligent here. They are inventing, discovering so many scientific things by dint of their scientific research to give more and more comfort to this mental body. Day by day they are doing, isn't it? Still, there is fear, there is anxiety, isn't it? The person, the very materially intelligent person makes so many plans, so many projects for this, fulfill this bodily needs, toils very hard. Do you understand? He toils very hard the whole day. The whole day he toils very hard. Like an ass. Gardhaver moto ami kori parishram. You understand? Like an ass he toils very hard. Have you seen ass? Mr. Peter, you have seen ass?
I have seen many.
Ass toils very hard. For only two purposes. Do you understand? What are those two purposes?
Eating and having sex.
Yeah. For a bundle of grass and to have sex with sea ass. Do you understand? She runs that he ass runs behind the sea ass for sex. And what the sea ass does, do you know? Kicks. Gardhava padotarita. Karabata padotarita. Do you understand, Mr. Peter? She kicks with her hind legs, still runs. Like us. Gardhaver mato ami kori parishram. You see? Like us, they are toiling. This materialistic persons, those who know only this material body. And making so many plans and projects to give more comforts, more happiness, newer comforts and newer happiness to this body. You understand? The whole day they run, they engage themselves, toil very hard, like an ass. Ahani aprutartha karana, Srimad Bhagavatam says. Ahani aprutartha karana, nisi nisoyana. Nana manarathadhiya khyana bhagna nidra daiva hatartha rachana rusayo pideva jusmat prasanga vimukha yaha sansaranti. Do you understand, Mr. Peter? Srimad Bhagavatam says, Srimad Bhagavatam pramanam amalam. Srimad Bhagavatam pramanam amalam. Spotless proof. Do you understand? Spotless proof. No wrong, no mistake here. Bhagavata de namani says avanasama. Tar sastra says anme anme prabhujama. What Bhagavad says, if you won't accept, you are mlecho javan. You understand? Those who do not accept Srimad Bhagavatam, they are mlecho javanas. They will be punished life after life by Jamaraj. Tar sastra says janme janme prabhujama. You understand? Life after life. Punished by Jamaraj. Do you understand me, Mr. Peter? Srimad Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada Maharaj, my grand guru, my guru also, previous wisdom. All Mahajanas say, do you understand? This Srimad Bhagavatam must impartial scripture, impartial, no partial. Srimad Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada Maharaj says, if all the books from the library of the world will be destroyed, there will be no harm if only Srimad Bhagavatam is there. Do you understand? Mr. Peter. If only Srimad Bhagavatam is there, and if all other books will be destroyed from the library of the world, there will be no harm, no harm. You understand? Srimad Bhagavatam is such a scripture. Pramana mavalam, spotless proof. One should accept it. Accept it. Srimad Bhagavatam says, Ahoni aprutartha karana nisi niso yana. Nana manartha dhiya. Kshano bhogno nidra. You see. The whole day, these materialistic persons, those who are in bodily conception of life, toil very hard. Struggle so hard. Do you understand? In different ways, in many ways, they engage their senses in materialistic activities. Isn't it? You'll see. If I, you see how they are toiling, how they are engaging themselves in various materialistic activities the whole day. Some is doing labor. Some is engaged as a laborer, daily laborer, wage earner. And some is working in the government offices, and some is sitting on the nice cushioned chair in the court, you understand, judge, and some has become the president of the state, prime minister of the state, like that, whatever they are doing, you understand, various ways. They are engaged in materialistic activities the whole day toiling. Ahani aprutartha karana. After toiling the whole day, when it is evening, night comes, they come back to their residence, house, to sleep, to take rest. You understand? But nisi nisoyana cannot sleep. No sleep, Baba, no sleep. Do you understand? The whole day, they toil. They come to take rest, to sleep, but no sleep. Why? They cannot sleep. No sleep, sleepless night. Do you understand? For what reason?
Too much anxiety.
too much anxiety. Too much anxiety. Yes. Nisi nisoyana nana manarata diya kyoro bhogno nidra. So much anxiety, so many plans, projects, all these thoughts are haunting their mind. You understand? Haunting. So, if you are in anxiety, there will be no sleep at all. They go to doctor. Oh, doctor, I cannot have sleep. Please give me some medicine. I may sleep. The doctor gives him sleeping pill. Isn't it? Take the sleeping pill. He is so much sleeping pill. You understand? Statistics has been collected. In this Western world, many people use this sleeping pill to sleep. Drugs, isn't it? Drugs they take to sleep. Intoxicants. They use such heavy amount. If you accumulate them, it will be greater than Himalayan mountain per day, per one day. Just used so much. But they cannot sleep. Nisi nisoyana nana manartadiya kyono bhogno nidra. So many materialistic thoughts hunting the mind. If by chance some little sleep comes, still that sleep breaks. Do you understand? They have accumulated so much black money. Do you understand? Black money. And they have kept Alsatian dogs to guard. During night time, dacoit will come, thief will come, government people will come to assess income tax or seize his wealth. You understand? That anxiety is also there. You understand? So they have kept this Alsatian dogs, the dog barks, bah, 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 ah, ah, dacoit, dacoit, thief, thief. You see? The sleep breaks. Do you understand? Nana manardadiya kyano bhogno nidra. No sleep, Baba. What sort of life? Is it happy life? Enjoying? Enjoying? You can't have sleep? You see? Nana manardadiya kyano bhogno nidra. Daiva hodartha rachana. Rusayo pideva. Jusmat prasanga vimukha. Yahasansaranti. So many plans, so many projects they have made. But Daiva, the providence, breaks everything. You understand? The Supreme Lord doesn't give sanction to it. All their plans and projects failed. Loss. Heavy loss. Do you understand? Mr. Peter. Huh? You take statistics. Very expert plan makers are there in this material world. Very expert plan makers. They are making so much plans, so many plans for material comfort, material enjoyment. But all plans are foiled. All plans. Do you understand? Run in loss. Do you understand? Crores of dollars they spend, still no gain. Loss, loss, loss. Why is it so? Why is it so? Because daiva hota artha rachana. That providence, the Supreme Lord, doesn't give sanction. Do you understand? Krishna said that thing. Srimad Bhagavad-gita. Anumanta upadrashta bharta bhokta maheshwara. He said, I am the ultimate sanctioning authority. Isn't it? I am the ultimate sanctioning authority. Unless Krishna sanctions, nothing will take place. Will anything take place? Madhvayat bhati bhato yam मद्भयाद्वाति बात वयम हाँ सूर्यम तपति इंद्र वर्षति अग्नि दहति मृत्यु चरति मद्भयात। लॉर्ड कपिलदेव सेज मद्भयाद्वाति बात वयम फियरिंग मी दिस विंड ब्लोज carrying out my order, the sun gives heat and light and heat, carrying out my order, the fire god burns, carrying out my order, fearing me, Lord Indra gives rain, you understand, Indra Varsati, Mrityuscharati Madhubhayat, fearing me, Jamaraj comes as death. Do you understand? Unless Krishna wills, even a blade of grass will not shake. Isn't it? Do you understand? Mr. P. His sanction, his ultimate sanctioning authority, Anumanta. And he has said that thing in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. But these plan makers, they make so many plans, projects, material plans and projects for material comforts, happiness, enjoyment, but fail because Supreme Lord doesn't sanction. Do you understand? Doesn't sanction. Doesn't give sanction. Daiva hatartha rachana rushayo pi deva jismat prasanga vimukha yah sansaranti. By making so many material plans and projects by dint of your material intelligence, you understand? Merit, whatever may, you may for some time occupy some higher position here in this material world. You understand? You may occupy. One may become prime minister of the state, isn't it? One may much higher than that, occupy the heavenly planet, become a demigod for enjoyment. The heavenly planet, much enjoyment. You cannot imagine, so much enjoyment is there. Do you understand? You may make like that and may occupy such position. दैवहतार्थ रचना रुषयोपि देवा जस्मत् प्रसंग विमुखा यह संसरन्ति। बट इफ यू विल नॉट बी इंटरेस्टेड अट्रैक्टेड टुवर्ड्स कृष्ण और कृष्ण कथा एंड यू आर अट्रैक्टेड टू दिस माया इल्यूजरी एनर्जी यू अंडरस्टैंड मेटेरियलिस्टिक एंजॉयमेंट दैट मीन्स यू आर कैप्चर्ड बाय माया. You are attracted towards Maya. You are not attracted towards the all-beautiful Krishna or Krishna Katha. However, a great elevated position you may occupy, fall down and they are falling down. Jusmat prasanga vimukha yah sansaranti. Do you understand? Srimad Bhagavatam says, so they are always in anxiety, fearful state. What will happen? Oh, thief came, dacoit came, dog is barking, government people come to assess income tax and seize my wealth. Isn't it? So much anxiety. Every state, they cannot sleep. Is this happy life? Making so much arrangements, still no happiness. No happiness, no pleasure, always anxiety. What sort of life? You understand? What sort of life it is? Because bhayam ditiyo bhinivesata syat. Why they are in fearful state? Because their attention is there other than Krishna. In all material objects, material enjoyment. You understand? Only our attention will be at the lotus feet of Krishna. This is the only thing. You understand? Therefore, Srimad Bhagavatam says, Bhayam Ditya Vinivesava. Syat. That is the reason of bhaya. Fear. You understand? That is the reason of fear. Because we have not paid our attention, or we have not concentrated our mind at the lotus feet of Krishna. We have paid our attention to illusory energy, illusory enjoyment, materialistic objects, other than this, other than the lotus feet of Krishna. Therefore, we are in fear. Do you understand? We are in fear. This is the reason of fear. That when someone who is fortunate, intelligent, he will turn his face towards the lotus feet of Krishna and fixes his mind, all attention at the lotus feet of Krishna, then there will be no fear. He will become fearless. Here it is said, your lotus feet which bestows fearlessness upon all who surrender to them. Markandeya Rishi says, Krishna says, all say. Do you understand? Abhaya asaka amrutera sthala tomara charana daya. Bhakti Vinod Thakur Mahajan says, do you understand? Asaka abhaya amrutera sthala tomara charana daya. O Lord, your lotus feet is such a place. There is no fear, no lamentation, no death. You understand, Mr. Peter? If someone will take complete surrender at the lotus feet of Krishna, so he will be fearless. There is no fear, no lamentation, asoka, and amruta, no death. All are afraid of death, isn't it? All are in anxiety. What will happen to my body? What will happen to my accumulated wealth, property? What will happen to my bank balance? What will happen to my wife? What will happen to my children? Oh, Bobo. Oh, these are anxiety. Every step, Every step, there is danger. Nobody is free from anxiety here, this material world. But one was completely taken shelter at the lotus feet of Krishna. He is fearless. He is never afraid of any situation here in this material world. You understand? He is never afraid of any situation. He's fearless. No lamentation, ashoka, and also he conquers death. No death. Bhakti Vinod Thakur has said that thing. Ashoka abhaya amrutera sthala tumara charana daya. O Lord, the lotus feet, your lotus feet is such a place where there is no fear, no lamentation, and no death. No death. Do you understand? And now I take shelter, as Markandeya Rishi says, O Lord Hari, I take shelter of the souls of your lotus feet, which bestow fearlessness upon all who are surrendered there. And Bhakti Vinod Thakur also says the same thing. O Lord, now I completely take shelter at your lotus feet. Now I become fearless. Do you understand? Charili bhavoro bhoyo. Charili bhavoro bhoyo. Bhavo bhoyo. Bhavo means the material world. Bhoyo means fear. Now I am free from all these materialistic fears, taking shelter of your lotus feet, O Lord. Do you understand? Very nice, Mahajan. He has sung many songs. Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Do you know some of his songs? Huh? Do you know? Mr. Peter? Huh?
A little bit.
What? What do you know?
The song about he's talking to the mind.
Yeah.
Mind are you?
Huh?
What sort of mind are you? You want to chant Hare Krishna in a lonely place and
can you sing that song?
Manas. No, I can't. I only know the first word.
Yeah, I am singing one song. भूलिया तुम्हारे संसारे आसिया पे नाना विध व्यथा भूलिया तुम्हारे संसारे आसिया पे नाना विध तुम्हारो चरणी आसियो छी आमी बोलिबो दुखेर कोथा जथरे छिलाम जखन विषम बंधन पासे जननी जठरे छिलाम जखन विषम एक बारे प्रभु देखा दिया मोरे बंचिले ये दिन दासे एक बारे Do you understand? Let me say, I won't sing so much. You can't recite it. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, O Lord, forgetting you, I come to this material world which is full of misery, unhappiness, anxiety. Danger. You understand? Pe nana vidho vyatha. I am suffering from manifold miseries. So much pain, distress. I get here. Oh Lord. You understand? Tomaro charoni asiya ami bolibo dukhe rakata. Now I have come to your lotus feet. Now I have come to your lotus feet, oh Lord. I tell all my distress. Do you understand? Pain and distress and Janani jathare chilama jakhana bosam visama bandhana paase ekabare prabhu dekha diya amore banchilo ee dino dase. When I was in mother's womb, do you understand? Have you remembered those days, Mr. Peter? When you were in mother's womb?
No, I can't remember.
No, you have forgotten it. Very painful situation. Mother's womb is a very, very painful situation. Do you understand? Very, very painful situation. You have forgotten it. So, janma, the birth, is a misery. Janma, mrityu, jara, vyadhi. Birth, death, old age, and these are misery. Here in this material world. Do you understand? He says that. Janani jathare chilama jakhana visama bandhana paase. When I was in mother's womb, I was tied up there. Very strong bondage. Very miserable place. So much pain. I was afflicted with so much pain there. Do you understand? That's a fact. Ekabare prabhu dekha diya amore banchile ye dino dase. And there I have once seen you in the womb of mother. You understand? Have you seen him? Have you seen him, Supreme Lord, while he was in the womb of your mother? You have forgotten. You have forgotten. Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, Ekabar Prabhu dekha diya amore banchilo ye dino dase. Once I saw you there, in the mother's womb, O Lord, but you cheated me. You cheated me. I cannot see you anymore. Do you understand? Takhana bhavinu janama paya kariva bhajana tabo. Then I thought of, when I will come out of mother's womb, take birth, I must do your bhajan. Do you understand? I must do your bhajan. You have given that word to Supreme Lord, Mr. Peter. in the mother's womb. You have forgotten it. You understand, Mr. Peter? While you were in mother's womb, you have given this word to Supreme Lord. Oh Lord, please make me out of this painful situation. This time I will never forget you. I will do your bhajan. Huh? Are you lazy? Huh? Don't be lazy. We are not doing. Concentrated attention. Hear it attentively. You are in such a painful situation. Miserable situation. Huh? Can't you think it up? Can't you think it up? Huh?
I don't understand your question.
You can't understand me. Follow me. You can't think it up in what miserable condition you are. Huh? He is in fool's paradise. Fool's paradise. You understand? Fool's paradise. He can't think of that I am in such a miserable condition here. Oh no, very nice, very nice, very nice. It's fool's paradise. Don't be in fool's paradise, Baba. Don't. Think of seriously what miserable condition you are here. You understand? So he. Takhana bhavinu janama paya kariva bhajana tava. Then I thought of, I must do your bhajan, O Lord, this time, if you please make me out of this painful situation. You have given word, but what happens? Janama hoilo podi maya jale no hoilo jnana lobha. When you are born, came out of mother's womb, you are captured by Maya, attracted by Maya. You lose all your knowledge, all your remembrance, everything. What words you have given to him, that I'll do bhajan, but now no bhajan, Baba. Doing Maya's bhajan, Maya's bhajan, no Hari bhajan. Isn't it, Mr. Peter? You see. আদরের ও ছেলে সজনের বলে হাসিয়া কাটানো কালো বাবালো আদরের ও ছেলে সজনের বলে হাসিয়া কাটানো কালো না ইউ আর সো মাচ চ্যান্টেড বাই ইলুজারি এনার্জি ডু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড অ্যান্ড ট্রাইং টু এনজয় মায়া ইউ হ্যাভ নাইস ওয়াইফ নাইস চিলড্রেন Nice relatives. You understand? Among them, you are trying to enjoy. You understand? Hasya katinu kalo. I just, my whole time is now spent in all these activities. Nidraya hiyote noktam bebaye na chabavaya. Divacha artha. Upajane. Kutumba bharane nova. How your time is spent, Baba? Here. Mr. Peter.
In Maya.
Divacharto. You understand? Nidrayaryotinoktam. Bevayeno chobabayo. The whole day time is spent in earning money, 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 money. How can I get money, 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 money? Toiling very hard, like an ass. Making so many plans and projects to get more money, more money, more money. Therefore, I'll more enjoy, enjoy, more enjoy. Isn't it? The whole day is spent like that. The whole night. Huh? Nidraya hriyote noktam bevayi no chobavaya. The whole night is spent in either sleep or sex enjoyment. Sex enjoyment. Isn't it? Night is spent. Do you understand? Divacharto. Kutumbo varaninuva. The whole day, you are thinking of how to maintain my family, my wife, my children, how to earn more money. Whole day you are engaged in this activity and whole night is spent either sleeping or in sex enjoyment. But you are not thinking of what words you have given to him. This time, please make me out from this painful situation. Oh Lord, I'll do your bhajan. Where is bhajan? No bhajan, Baba. No bhajan. Forgotten, you see. That's it. Janaka janani snehate bhulya sansaro lagilo bolo. Oh, oh, oh. Hey, it's a fool's paradise. Very nice. My wife is there, my children are there, my kith and kin are there, relatives are there. Oh, it's a very nice place, enjoyment, place of enjoyment. Oh, Hari, oh Lord Hari, forgetting you, I am engrossed on these activities. Krame dino dino baloko hoya, khelinu baloko sa, aro kichu dine gyano upujilo. Patho podi oho raha. Then you gradually grow up, become a boy. So with the same aged boys, you play. You are engaged in so many plays. Isn't it? No, Krishna bhajan, Hari bhajan. Then you are sent to the schools, colleges, university to acquire knowledge, education, to get some education. Isn't it? Then vidyara gaurave bhrami deshe deshe dhana uparjana kari sodana palana kari ekamane bhulinu tumare hari. Then after completing your university course or school course, acquiring some knowledge, then you seek job. I must have a job and earn money. It is not available, let us go there. Now this cartel has come, let us go to Australia. I cannot get job here in India. Many have come to for job here, isn't it? Yes. Vidyara gaurave bhrami deshe deshe. Go to Australia, go to America, go to Europe, let us go. Have a job, earn money. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, to earn money, dhana uparjana kari, sodana palana kari ekamane bhulinu tumare hari. I forget you completely, O Hari, being engaged in all these activities. All my life is gone now, spent now. Isn't it? This thing is going on. Bardhokye khona bhakati vinoda kandiya katarati na bhajyatare dina vruthagalo. Ekhono ki hobe goti. Do you understand? Now old age has come. Grey hair. Cannot see nicely, cannot hear nicely. Tooth have fallen down. And a bent now is breaking. Cannot walk, stumbling. You see the old age. Mr. Peter. Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bardhakya means old age. Bardhakya ekhono bhakati vinoda kandiya. Now crying. Oh, now crying. Na bhajyatare dina vruthagelo ekhono ki hobe gati. Oh Lord, I couldn't do your bhajan. All my lifespan is spent now. What will be my destination now, Lord? You see, it's crying. Such is the lot here, this metal stick. Persons, you understand, metal stick persons. Pidayo sthiro chintaye jorito bhave jolito chito. Upayo na dekhi andhokaro mayo ekhono haichi bhito. You see, bhito now I am up. Afraid. I have so much anxiety, so much deficit. I earn so much money, still deficit, still in want. You understand? upaya. I cannot find out any way, any means. Oh Lord, I saw everything dark, everything dark. Andhokaramayo. I am so much afraid. I am such a fearful state. Ekono hoichi bhito. You see, this is fear. Sansara toti nisrata na hesata marana nikate ghor. Sar samapya bhajiva tumai yasa bifala mora. I thought, all right, I'll let me have finish all these activities, materialistic activities, family maintenance, you understand, taking care of children, taking care of family. All I finish all this, then I'll do your bhajan. I will do your bhajan. But now I have lost that hope, O Lord. I have lost that hope. Evesma Prabhu, amigatihina bhagati vinodakai. Tavakrubhavina sakali nirasa dehomuri padasva. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, O Lord, I am lost my way. Without your mercy, without taking shelter at your lotus feet, I have no place. Who will protect me? You understand? Therefore, Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, now I take shelter of your lotus feet, O Krishna, O Lord Hari, and now I am free from all anxiety, all fear, all. Ebe atma samarpane chinta nahi aar. Now I am free from all anxiety, all fear, by taking shelter at your lotus feet, which is a place of fearlessness. Do you understand? There is no lamentation and there is no death. Now I am free from all anxiety, all lamentation, all fear. Now I am very happy. You understand? All Shastra say this thing. All Mahajanas, they say this thing. You understand? And Markandeya Rishi also here says the same thing. And Krishna says that thing. This is a latest concluding instruction in Bhagavad Gita. Sarva dharmana parityajya mamekam saranam vraja antam sarva papebhyo mukhishyami ma shucha. Don't fear. Don't fear. Take shelter of me, of my lotus feet, fearlessly. Fearlessly take shelter. Don't fear. You understand? Don't fear. If you think that by giving up all religion you will commit some sin, I will protect you from all sinful reactions. Don't fear. He says, assures. He assures. He gives us assurance of fearlessness. You understand? And also in Srimad Bhagavatam 5. Narayana para sarve na kutaschana vibhyati sarga pavarga narakesu api tulyartha darsina. Isn't it? Gopinath, you know? Huh?
Taking shelter of Lord Narayana.
Yeah.
He has no fear whether he goes to the heavenly planets.
Yes.
Liberation, whether he goes to the hellish planets.
You see, Gopinath knows. Narayana parasarvena kutaschana vibhyati sargapavarga narakeswapi tulyartha darsina. Do you understand? Those who have taken shelter at the lotus of Lord Narayana, they are never afraid of any situation here in this material world. They are never afraid of any situation. Sarga, apavarga, narka. Do you understand, Mr. Pitta? Sarga means heavenly planet. Apavarga, Brahman effulgence, narka, hell. Do you understand? Sarga, apavarga, narka, esopi. Tulyartha darsina. You have difficulty, your head aches, I mean say leg aches, go and stand there. Go at the door, stand up, go. If you can't sit, you're not accustomed to sit, your leg aches.
I'm sorry, just
you go and stand there, behind. Stand up, stand up. Don't stretch your head here, leg here. Go and stand up there at the door. Stand up. Yes. Go there, stand. You understand, Mr. Peter? Narayana parasarpe na kutaschana vibhyati surgapavarga narakesvapi tulyarthadarsina. They are never afraid of any situation. Even if they will be placed at surga, heavenly planet, or if they will be placed at narka, hell. Hell. Or if they will be placed in Brahman effulgence, still they are not afraid of that situation. They see everything equal. Everything equal for them. Surga, the heavenly planet, the hell, hellish planet, and Brahman effulgence are all equal to them. How is it? Is it equal? Is the hell is equal to heaven? Or Brahman effulgence equal to hell or heaven? Is it equal?
Materially, no.
Then, spiritually, yes. Materially, not spiritually, yes. What do you say? Only in theorizing, or you have some practical experience? theorizing. Mr. Peter, don't theorize. They say, Narayana parasarve na kudasana vibhyati surgapavarga narakesavi tulyarthadasana. Those who are Narayana para, those who have taken complete shelter at the lotus feet of Lord Narayana, they feel all these places equal. It may be heavenly planet or hell or Brahman, everything equal for them. Why? Because they are Narayana para. They have taken shelter at the lotus feet of Lord Narayana. Wherever they are, they have taken shelter at the lotus feet of Lord Narayana. Narayana is there. Do you understand? One who has taken complete shelter at the lotus feet of Lord Narayana, and only one duty he has, one service he has, to serve the lotus feet of Lord Narayana, wherever he may be. Maybe in heaven, or maybe in hell, or maybe in Brahman effulgence. I will only serve the lotus feet of Lord Narayana, nothing else. So Lord Narayana will be there. Then, sir, isn't it? Where there is Lord Narayana, will it be hell? Or will it be heaven? Or will it be Brahman effulgence? It is Vaikuntha. Isn't it? Where there is Lord Narayana, it is Vaikuntha. It is neither hell, nor heaven, nor Brahman effulgence. It is equal to them. This means so. So they are not afraid of any situation. You understand? Na kutaschana vibhyati. You see, fear is now gone. All anxiety is now gone. They are so happy. Do you understand? They are so happy. They get so much pleasure. It's transcendental pleasure. Not material pleasure. Material pleasure is no pleasure at all. It is misery. Source of all misery. Anxiety. Do you understand? Especially in this Kali Yuga, the instruction is for us to take complete shelter at the holy name of the Lord. Isn't it? They complete shelter at the holy name of the Lord. Why? Why?
Because there's no other way. There's no other way.
No other way. Why don't you take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna? Why complete shelter of the holy name?
There's no difference.
Yes? Tell me.
Why don't I take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna? Is that what you said?
Lotus feet. Why his holy name?
Why the holy name?
Yes.
Well, Krishna and his name are non-different.
No difference. Yeah. That's all right. There's no difference between the name of Krishna and Krishna himself. So why it is said that takes shelter of holy name. Why not take shelter of their lotus feet of Krishna? In this Kali Yuga. You don't know?
No.
Kali Yuga Namo Sangye Krishna Avataro. Namo hoite hoye sarvo jagato nistaro.
Namo hoite hoye sarvo jagato nistaro.
Namo bina koli kali nai aro dharma.
Namo
Namase paramatattva shastrero vidhano.
Namase paramatattva shastrero vidhano.
Do you understand? Kali kale namasange Krishna avatar. In Kali Yuga, it is name incarnation. Krishna has incarnated himself in the form of his holy name in Kali Yuga. Do you understand? Kali Kale Nama Sangi Krishna Avatar. Do you understand? That is the reason. No other incarnation is there in Kali Yuga. Mr. Peter is name incarnation. Do you understand? Therefore we take shelter of the holy name. Nama Sangi Krishna Avatar. Nama Hoite Hoye Sarva Jagat Nistar. If you can take shelter of the holy name, there will be no fear. Do you understand? You will conquer fear. You will become fearless. Have you become? No. You have not taken shelter. That's the reason. That's the reason. That's the reason. You have not taken shelter, Mr. Peter. Therefore you are in such a fearful state. Fearful state, isn't it? Nama vina kali kale nahi aro dharma. No other dharma is there. The only name, except name. Do you understand? And name is everything. And this is the siddhanta given in all Vedic scriptures, in all shastras. Do you understand? Harinam, harinam. अरे नामेव केवलम कलौ नास्तेव 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 गतिरन्यथा उपनिषद से वेद से नो अदर वे इन कलि युग ओनली टेक शेल्टर ऑफ हरि नाम यू अंडरस्टैंड नामेक शरणत्व एंड महाप्रभु के हु इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम कृष्ण इज कृष्ण हिमसेल्फ ही सेड टेक शेल्टर ऑफ दिस होली नेम हां Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Bolo. Says, Mahaprabhu says, Prabhu kahe kahilamo ei maha mantra.
Prabhu kahe kahilamo ei maha mantra.
Prabhu kahe kahilamo ei maha mantra. Do you understand? Prabhu means Mahaprabhu. Sriman Mahaprabhu says, I tell you this Mahamantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. I tell you this Mahamantra. Prabhu kahe kahilama yaha mantra. Yaha japa gya kuriya nirbandha. Do you understand? Do this bhajan of this name. Chant this name. Do you understand? Chant this name, Mahamantra. With all seriousness, taking complete shelter unto this holy name. Yaha japagya kuryan. Yaha vitya sarva siddhi hoive sabar. Sarvakshana valaite vidhinaya. This is Mahaprabhu's order. You understand? You can achieve all perfection, Mr. Peter. Sarva siddhi. The name will give you everything. You understand? Mahaprabhu's order. Highest perfection, supreme perfection you can achieve. The name will give you. Krishna pray, will get Krishna and go back home, back to God. Sarva siddhi hoive sabar. Sarva kyana vala. Yesterday evening I was telling you, chant incessantly without losing one moment. Ki soyone, ki bhojone, ki vajagarone. Yesterday evening, have you remember? I told Mahaprabhu's order, Mahaprabhu's instruction. Don't miss a moment. In the sleeping state, in wakeful state, dreaming state, in all moment, every moment, chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Don't forget it for a moment. You understand? Yahaite sarva siddhi hoive sabar, sarva kshana valaite vidhinayat. Mahaprabhu says, no, vidhi is there. No regulation is there. No vidhi. No, whatever state you are, you chant Hare Krishna. Do you understand? Nam nam kari baudha nija sarva sakti tatrat pita niyamita smarani no kala. Sikhyastaka? You know Sikhyastaka? Parrot-like reciting. Nam nam kari baudha nija sarva sakti tatrarpita niyamita smarani no kala. Etadrusita bakrupa bhagavan mamapi durdai vaidrusi mihajani nam raga. Sikhyastaka? Mahaprabhu says, O Lord, you have showered so much mercy, etadrusita bakrupa, and put everything in your holy name, and no regulation. You gave such opportunity, but I am such a rascal. Mr. Peter is such a rascal. And such a rascal, I cannot develop interest in it, develop attraction towards it. Isn't it? Such mercy. But I cannot have it. I'm such a rascal. Durdaiva idrusi, mahajani nanuraga. I'm such a rascal. I cannot take interest in it. I'm not attracted to it. Isn't it, Mr. Peter? Jai jana bhaje Krishna se vado chatur. Who is intelligent?
Person that takes shelter of the holy name.
Yeah. Jai jana bhaje Krishna se vado chatur. When who does Krishna bhajan, he is intelligent. Do you understand? He is intelligent person. Do you understand? If that in some intelligent person takes complete shelter at the holy name, what happens, do you know? He becomes fearless. No fear, no anxiety. Do you understand? Why are you in anxiety, Mr. Peter? Why are you in a fearful state, Mr. Peter? Jat vibheti swayam bhayam, it is said in Shastra. Jat vibheti swayam bhayam. When someone takes complete shelter at the holy name of Lord, the bhaya, the fear itself is afraid of. Do you understand? Fear itself is afraid of. Oh, Mr. Peter has now taken complete shelter of holy name. So that fear will be afraid of to approach you. Jat vibheti swayam bhayam. You see, such fearlessness. Do you understand me, Mr. Peter? So, I request you one and all, take shelter of this holy name and become fearless. Thank you very much.